thanks a lot for that intro. So I'm going to talk about how prediction markets can reduce uncertainty and enable decentralized governance. So I will start really shortly with kind of three slides on what are prediction markets and what they are usually good for. So usually they are good for information gathering, but then I want to go into those two use cases from the title. So what do you need for prediction markets? Prediction markets are basically a tool to turn any kind of information into a market. So you want to know whether or not something is happening in the future, and you just create a market out of it. And by doing that, you allow everyone who has some idea or some opinion about this event happening or not happening to use this information or to trade on this market. And by doing that, kind of feeding their private information into the market and getting a better public forecast of that thing. So you need a few things. You need to clearly specify what is the question you are asking. You need eventually an oracle, someone who determines the outcome, some source of information, and you need a currency. And we will look at a simple example. So you take some collateral token, that's how we call it, that could be a US dollar, and you define different outcomes. So you could look at things like Chris was talking earlier in his talk about evaluation of crypto assets. You might be interested in what is the throughput or what is the transaction capacity or the transaction volume of Ethereum. And you, for example, you could define three outcomes. It's more than a million, it's 0 to 1 million transactions a day, it's 1 million to 10 million transactions a day, or it's more than 10 million. Those are your three outcomes. And so you create those three outcomes, and those are tokens. And they are worth, if that specific outcome happens, then they are worth that collateral. So again, you put in $1 as collateral, and if at a specific time, so let's say in a year, you have this kind of outcome A, then this outcome A token will have a value or can be redeemed for $1. If outcome B happens, then that can be redeemed for $1 or C. So here, again, another example. The question in this case would be, is the northeast passage, will it be possible to navigate through it? Kind of, is it ice-free? And the outcomes are yes and no. And over time, you trade those tokens, and the market price of those tokens is the likelihood of that happening. So if the yes outcome tokens trade at 60 cents a dollar, then that means the market gives the likelihood of that event a chance of 60%. If you think the chance is higher, you should buy that outcome token because, then you will make money if you're right. And by that, you will influence the price and create a better forecast. So a few things we can do with Gnosis or with prediction markets in general. We make future outcomes tradable. We have a great way to aggregate the relevant information. We filter out all the noise. The big advantage of having that on the blockchain is that we create a global liquidity pool. And we can actually aggregate information not only from humans, but also AIs could participate in those markets. So that was kind of the 3-minute summary of prediction markets. And now I'm talking about the two use cases of how you can use those tools to reduce risk and do decentralized governance. So first, very similar picture to what you saw a minute ago, but now we can also use tokens, kind of the type of utility tokens or equity tokens everyone is talking about, and we can use those as how we call it collateral tokens. And what you essentially can do is you can use such a token of a new project, of a new product, and usually they have their roadmap. And you can ask a simple question: will they hit their first milestone, let's say in a year? Yes or no. And if you apply the very same mechanisms and use that token, then you create here on the right side essentially a version of that token under the condition that they hit their first milestone. So you have the token under the condition that they hit their first milestone and do their first release, or that they don't hit the target. So as a trader, that allows you to be very selective about what risk you're wanting to take. So in the traditional kind of token trading as it is today, if you buy the token, you're of course taking many risks at once. So you're taking the risk whether or not the team is actually capable of delivering, whether the market conditions are right, whether there might be regulatory uncertainty. With those conditional tokens, you can exactly pick the risk you want to take. So let's say you know it's a great idea, and you think you want to kind of bet on the market conditions, and you think, well, the project is good, but you have no idea whether the team will be able to deliver what they are promising. In that case, you might want to kind of just buy the token, but only under the condition. So you make the commitment to buy the token, but only under the condition that they deliver. And if they don't, well, you just you have a neutral position, or you just kind of get your money back in a way. Or the other way around, you know, okay, the team is great. You know they will deliver. You know them, but you're not so certain about kind of the market conditions. Or regulatory conditions. So in that case, you might want to purely make a prediction on yes, that team is capable of delivering. So what we do with that is we create much more fine, more granular ways to put your specific, or to make use of your specific knowledge or of your specific thesis. So now, what I just described now here is kind of an observing market. So you observe, or you value future events. Kind of, if that would happen, then I already put a value to this token under that condition, or under that condition. Now we can go a step further, and this is really interesting in my opinion. You can use those mechanisms to actually make the decision in what direction to go. The concept is called futarchy and was invented by Robin Hanson, who's also an advisor to us. And it is about using prediction markets to actually make the decisions and to make, well, in a way, decentralized decisions. So with decision making, you usually have the problem that either you have a limited set of participants that can make a decision, then in a way you might miss knowledge that is out there. Someone kind of outside of that small circle might have some knowledge that would be useful in the decision making, but they don't have really a mechanism and also not an incentive to play a role in this decision making. Or it's kind of very open, but then you always have the problem of is it resilient? Is it kind of resilient against someone who wants to influence the process? And that's exactly where markets are very efficient. So I will walk you through how that works. In the first step, you need to define, if you're, for example, a decentralized project, one of those token projects or a blockchain, you need to define something that is measurable, a metric of what does success actually mean. So that could be maximizing transaction volume of a blockchain, that could be maximizing revenue of a company, that could be maximizing token price. So you first need to be clear, what do you actually want to achieve? A very explicit metric. And now, in the second process, you make different proposals, and then you use, again, those conditional markets. So I will walk you here through an example. So in this case, the question could be, should we fire the CEO? And the metric would be, what will be the revenue? And you create conditional markets. What will be the revenue under the condition we fire the CEO, or under the condition we don't? And you let the market trade, basically your this expectation for your metric for a specific time, and then you could automatically implement, and you can have that completely codified as a DAO and written in smart contracts, and the DAO would automatically implement the decision that maximizes the forecast or the prediction for your metric. So now the decision would be made. In this case, well, we would fire the CEO. And then after some time, finally, there will be an objective evaluation because at some point then, in this case, the revenue would be measured, and then those who are right, who were right with their forecast, well, they will earn, and if they were wrong, they will lose. So in that way, it is quite resilient to manipulation, because in the end, if you are wrong, or basically you are accountable for with that decision mechanism. It will always be measured in the end whether or not the decision led to the metric you want to improve. So again, why are those? Why is that specifically interesting for blockchains? It is a way to keep a network completely open, so anyone can participate in this decision-making process by trading. So by voicing an opinion about, well, I have an opinion about this metric or this token will be worth more if that decision is made, or I will actually sell all my tokens if that decision would be made. So you keep kind of the decision process open to everyone in the market, and everyone with information can participate and is accountable in the end. All right, so those were the two use cases I want to present: reducing risk and Futaki. Timeline: we currently have those conditional trading, we have it ready to support those conditional tokens. So now we really need to get people used to those new concepts to actually kind of trade a token, or only under specific conditions. So you would have eventually different prices for the token, depending on different possible futures. And as soon as we have that established, we can go even further and create those new, or at least do experiments with those new governance mechanisms. All right, thank you.